This video will show how to create a new job within the Leica Captivate field software. Within Leica Captivate, a job is basically the place where all data and measurements are stored, points measured with GNSS or with total stations, images, scans, setup records, codes, everything. One of the key aims when designing and developing Leica Captivate was to make basic, often repeated tasks as simple as possible, and how to make a new job is one of those tasks. We will now look at how to create a new job from the job carousel. Upon starting Leica Captivate, we will access the home screen. From here, we can see all of our jobs with their name and their associated image. This makes it much easier to identify and select the required job, especially if we have many. For a new job, we can simply scroll all the way to the left and see the option to create a new job. We can either tap on that or press OK to access this new job panel. When creating our new job, it is also possible to choose the coordinate system, choose the code list, set the total station scale factors, and attach files. So now we will look at doing those within the new job panel. In the general page tab, the name of the job must be entered, and additionally, optional information such as the description of the job or the name of the job's creator can also be added. Here, we can choose whether to store the job to the internal memory or to the SD card, and there is also a checkbox that allows us to capture an image, but we'll come back to that in just a few minutes. In the coordinate system page tab, the coordinate system to be used with our job can be selected. By default, the coordinate system which was used by the last active job is suggested, but here we will go into the list and select a different one. A separate video will cover the different types of coordinate systems and their uses in more detail. Next, in the code list page tab, the code list to be used with our job can be selected. Now by default, the suggested code list is the code list which was last used, but just as with coordinate systems, it is easy to select a different one from the available list. Separate videos will cover code lists and the behaviour of coding and line work in more detail. In the CAD files page tab, all DXF and shapefiles, which are in the data folders of either the SD card or the internal memory, are now shown. The CAD file or files to be used with the job can be selected, although by default, none are selected. CAD files will be looked at in full detail in another video. In the TS scale page tab, the total station scale factor which should be used can be defined. By default, the last used method and values are suggested, but it's possible to modify these. Again, a separate video covers the use of scale factors in more detail. That is now all the page tabs visited, but before we store the new job, let's just return to the general page and discuss the ability to use a captured image as the job's album cover. That is, it is used to identify the job within the home screen. The checkbox at the bottom of this screen allows us to take a picture once we stored a job. So let's check that box. Now, when we press store, we'll create and store a job and the capture image with camera panel will be shown. It could be used in the camera from the Leica CS20, the camera from the Leica CS35, or one of the total station or multi-station cameras. But regardless of this, the procedure is the same. We simply press capture to create the image. Here, we'll just take a photo of some project documentation. Leica Captivate then automatically takes us to the Image Viewer panel, where we can check if the image is as we desired, and if needed, we can sketch and annotate on the image too. We can add text or lines. We can select which color to use. We can select the line thickness. And with the eraser tool, we can even undo any mistakes. Once we are happy with the image, we can store it, which finalizes the job and returns us to the home screen. Here, we can see that the newly created job is placed in the center of the screen and is ready to be used. All we need to do is select an app from the app carousel, and then we can begin working.